pains and the lust of this world and the pride of life and the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes. I thank God for calling this old boy up out of sin. And I'm here tonight to tell you, Mobile, Alabama, that God can call you up out of your sin. All you have to do is be willing to lay down your life and be willing to lay down your will and be willing to pick up Jesus Christ and let him come into your heart and let him abode there and let him wash you clean and white as snow. I'm here to tell you, Mobile, Alabama, that Jesus Christ is coming again. And if you're found in sin, you shall not enter in. But Mobile, Alabama, there is a day coming when you're going to stand before a holy God and you're going to have to give an account for what you've done in this life, for what you've done in this life. I'm here to tell you, if you ain't done what God told you to do, he said, come out from amongst them and be ye separate, says the Lord of hosts. I'm here to tell you, you can't live in this world and do the things of this world and take partake of the things of this world. It is nothing but going to send you straight to a devil's hell. I'm here to tell you, Mobile, Alabama, that Jesus Christ has come here this Thursday night to tell you that there is a way out of your sin, that there is a way up out of the depravities of sin that you live in. And his name is Jesus Christ. He'll come in and he'll cleanse you and he'll take all your sin away. But you have to be willing to lay down your life. You have to be willing to die to you have to be willing to die to yourself and live to God and his son Jesus Christ. I'm here to tell you, Mobile, there is none righteous, no, not one, but the one that is the righteous one of everything, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm a man. I can let you down. I can tell you wrong, but I'm here to tell you, if you don't choose Jesus Christ and you don't turn from your sins, you'll die and you'll go to a devil's hell where it's burning. It's utter darkness, gnashing of teeth, where the worm dies not. I'm here to tell you, there was a young man a couple of days ago that they found on the side of an old dirt road. It says in Romans chapter 3, what then? Are we better than they? No, in no wise. For we have proved both Jew and Gentile that they are all under sin. And it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. There is none that understandeth. There is none that seeketh after God. They are all gone out of the way. They are all together become unprofitable. There is none that doth good, no, not one. Their throats is an open sepulcher, where their tongues they have used deceit. Their poison of asps is under their lips. Those mouths is full of cursing and bitterness. Their feet are swift as to shed blood. Destruction and misery are in their ways, and the way of peace have they not known. There is no fear of God before their eyes. Now we know that with the things soever the law saith, it saith to them who are under the law, that every mouth may be stopped and all the world may become guilty before God. Therefore, by the deeds of the law, there shall no flesh be justified in his sight. For by the law is the knowledge of sin. But now the righteousness of God without the law is manifest, being witnessed by the law and the prophets, even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ unto all and upon all them that believe. For there is no difference, for all have sinned and all and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by the grace through the redemption of that is in Christ Jesus, who God has set forth to be perpetuation through faith in His blood, to declare His righteousness for the remission of sins that are past through the forbearance of God. To declare, I say, that this time His righteousness, that He might be just and the justifier of him which believeth in Jesus Christ. You cannot save yourself, sinner. You cannot save yourself, backslider. You cannot save yourself. Jesus Christ is the only one that can save you. You have to die to yourself. You have to lift up Jesus Christ. And you have to tell him, ask him into your heart. It says in Romans chapter 10, it says, confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ, that God raised Jesus Christ from the dead, and confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus. You have to confess with your mouth. You have to believe in your heart that He is risen, that He is on earth. He is sitting on the right hand side of God, and He is judging this world, and He is judging sinners. You have to die to yourself, sinner. You have to die to this world. You have to die to the lust of your flesh and the pride of life. You have to give God everything. You cannot do anything in yourself, Mobile, Alabama. I'm telling you right now, there's judges in this city right now that'll throw that gavel down, and they'll put judgment on you if you do bad. But there's one on the other side of glory that's sitting on the right hand side of the Father, which His name is the Lord Jesus Christ. And He is the one that can judge the quick and the dead. He says, do not be afraid of the ones that can kill the body and kill the body, but be afraid of the one that can put the body and the soul in hell. We have to die to ourselves. We have to raise in newness of life to Jesus Christ. I'm here to tell you, Mobile, Alabama, you can continue to drive down Schillinger's Road or Airport Boulevard and go to your sin and go to whatever you want to do. But I'm here to tell you, there's a day coming in the not so distant future that the Lord Jesus Christ is going to split the eastern skies, and He's going to call His church away. And I'm here to tell you, if you're not in that crowd of saints that'll go up to be with Him in heaven, you're going to die, and you're going to go to a devil's hell, and you're going to burn in utter torment as Lazarus and the rich man. The rich man died, and he opened his eyes up in hell, and he said, Father Abraham, he said, bid Lazarus to come and bring me water from my lips, for I'm in torment. I'm in torment. We have all the precious commodities of this world, but all he wanted was something that's so abundant on this earth. He wanted water for his lips, for he was in torment. I'm telling you, hell is a fire that'll burn hotter than any fire here on earth. You think the sun burns hot? You think down here in the south it gets hot in the summertime? But I'm here to tell you, there's a hell that's way hotter than any temperature on this earth. There's a hell that's way hotter than the sun that we revolve around. 366 days or 365 days a year. I'm hellish. If you don't repent of your sin and you don't come out of the sin that you're in and you don't accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior and come up out of the depravities of sin that you're living in, Mobile, Alabama, God's going to judge you. God's going to judge you. You need to come and you need to accept the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, none is righteous. No, not one. You can't save yourself, sinner. You can't save yourself, backslider. You can't save yourself. But God, in His foreknowledge, in His great mercy, in His great grace, sent His Son to die on a cruel and rugged cross on God top of Golgotha's hill, Calvary's cross, to die for you, sinner, to die
thank God that He called me up out of my sin. I'm here to tell you, He can call you up out of your sin right here tonight. But you got to be willing to die to yourself, sinner. You got to be willing to lay down your life and ask Jesus into your heart and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and ask Him into your heart, because He'll save you from a devil's hell. From a devil's hell. Hell's not meant for us, sinner. Hell's not meant for us. It's meant for the devil and his angels. But it enlarges itself every day. Why is that? Because man would rather live in darkness than to live in light. They would rather go after the pleasures of their flesh instead of dying to their flesh and taking up their cross daily and following the Lord Jesus Christ. Sinner, He can save you. He can bring you up out of your sin. He can save you, sinner. But all you have to do is be willing to ask Him into your heart. Ask Him into your heart. Ask Him into your heart. And let Him forgive you of your sins and bring you up out of the depravity that you think you got it so good. You think you got everything you need, but yet you're lacking. Yet you're lacking. It says multitudes and multitudes in the valley of decision. I'm telling you, there's multitudes underneath the sound of my voice tonight, right here in Mobile, Alabama, that you're on your way to hell. But I'm telling you, God seen you, and He sent old boy and old man of God out here to tell you that He can save you. He can bring you up out of the depravities of sin. But all you have to do is be willing to lay down your life and be willing to pick up Jesus Christ and be willing to walk after holiness and walk after righteousness. I'm telling you, God, He can save you. He can turn your darkness into day. He can turn your misery into peace. He can turn your depravities into joy. He can turn everything you think you got. You're miserable tonight. You're miserable tonight. When you're going down and you hear the word of God being proclaimed, and you get mad and you get angry in your heart, but yet there's something there that's telling you, you need to hear what He's saying. You need to hear what they're saying. I'm here to tell you, God can save you. God can deliver you. God can set you free. But all you have to do is be willing to die. Die to self. Die to the flesh. And let God save your, never dying soul. Oh God, thank you. Thank you, God.